Okay.
Yes, Mr. as for me, Adams. I've never been shot.
You've never been shot?
No, I have gone.
I
read a lot, and I, you know, obviously I studied criminology and how criminals behave and so on. So probably I was more lucky because Mr. Leng has also studied strategy and how to protect yourself as well as the community. But I've had, you know, at least two policemen being shot and killed right around me. I remember when we were in Western Kingston, and we went to retrieve guns and ammunition, and drugs had just recently come in. And, you know, to cut it short, we were attacked. And I remember right along Spanish Town Road, in the vicinity of this old theater, is it?
Ambassador? The what, Majestic?
Majestic.
Okay.
You know, and they started firing from every angle. I don't want to really identify the place now because, you know, you have decent people living in these areas, and you don't want to make it appear as if you are highlighting anything negative about them. And I actually saw the gunshots being fired and piercing the asphalt. And my bodyguard then, or one of my bodyguards then, who was a Corporal Henry, he devastated him to the extent that he said, "Superintendent, I'm going to leave the area." And he got up and was shot in his groin. And, you know, I said to the men, well, we have to get out here alive. So I started crawling on my back for chains, as well as the other men, and so on. But that is really history. The closest, however, was when in 1975, with the same Tony Hewitt here, was leading the squad in 3 miles. In those days, they just started criminal activities using cars. And we heard that this car had been robbing Kingston all weekend. It was actually Christmas Eve. And they came to 3 Mile, we saw the car, we stopped the car. A shootout ensued. They ran into the bank at 3 Mile. No, at that time, they never had the fencing. But there was some lily trees and so on. 2 men were shot, 3 firearms recovered. And a third had run into the bank. We went there searching. And, you know, instinctively, I lift the lily tree. And as I did it, I heard bam, bam, bam. And the man was there and fired at me. And all I did was to have thrown myself backwards. And another man obviously shot him at the time, and he was fatally wounded. And we took from him another 9mm pistol. But, you know, I have never taken notice. As long as I came out of a situation alive, I never really reflected on it.
I understand.
You know, I have saved a lot of policemen life too and all that by taking action that they could not have taken. But for me, I've never, I don't know why, I don't know danger. I can't observe danger. I don't know what is dangerous. The more the danger confronts me as it relates to criminal elements, is the more spear-fierce I become.
You just go right
into
it.
I just go right into it. I like challenge. It's like in my time when I was serving. If a day passed and Perkins didn't criticize me, I would have been unhappy. So it's the same thing. When you, it's like when you go into these confrontations, and you know, it's like you were happy doing it. But at the end of the day, when you went home and all that, you reflected. And you're going to, you become very remorseful because people lost their lives. Whether it's a criminal element, yes or no, you're not out there to really eliminate people. You would have wanted to operate it in a way that people were taken in and sent to prison and all that stuff. But the criminal elements that we confront nowadays, they are so brazen and they never give up. So what you have to do is just keep on pushing the beer in it.
And that's why we need good police officers. Like you said, they never give up. But we have to take a break, though. When we do come back, we'll still be hearing from Renito Adams and Isaiah Leng. They have some interesting stories. We'll be right back.